Okay, so welcome to my sixth video in this series on the nervous system, and this one to do with conditioning. So as a quick introduction to conditioning, if you take a look at the following clips. Okay, so you should all probably recognise what those symbols are, and this is a form of conditioning. Okay, so we're probably aware of what this brand is. So this is the brand Mercedes. Now, you're all probably, because you've been exposed to it a number of times, you all realise that this symbol means the car brand Mercedes. But if you were to show this to someone who's had no exposure to advertising or any form of influence like that, then they wouldn't have any concept of this representing a car chain. The two things wouldn't seem to be linked. So what this shows us is this is a learned behaviour. You've learned that this symbol means Mercedes. Much in the same way that you've learned that this symbol means Pepsi, this one means HSBC, this one means McDonald's, and this one means Apple. So probably the most famous example of conditioning is to do with a guy called Pavlov, and he did a lot of work modelling conditioning in dogs. And so this diagram here shows us the methodology that he used. And so the first thing that he did was he presented the dog with the food, and obviously the dog began to salivate. So we can think of the food as our primary stimulus. It's the thing that was shown to the dog, and that caused the response, and the response in this case is salivation. So this diagram here shows us what happens before the dog had become conditioned. Now, the bell here is what's known as the secondary stimulus. So the bell being rang just on its own caused no response in the dog, as you would expect, because the dog hadn't learned that the bell was associated with the food yet. So this shows what happens before the conditioning. Now, his next thing that he did was he put the bell with the food. So every time the food was put down, Pavlov, or one of the people working on the experiment, rang the bell as well. And what happened was that the dog would salivate. And the dog would salivate because the presence of the food. Now, he repeated this over and over again. So every time he put the food down, he rang the bell. And he repeated this a number of times until the dog began to associate the food with the bell. Now, the final piece of the jigsaw is when he didn't put down the food and just rang the bell. Now, what happened at this point, because the dog associated the bell with the food, the dog began to salivate. And that's what's referred to as a conditioned response. The dog had learnt that the bell usually came along with the food, and hence salivation. So, just to summarise there then, you have the primary stimulus, which is the food, you have the secondary stimulus, which is the bell, and you have the response, which is salivation. And so in a conditioned response, what's technically happening is the secondary stimulus, or the bell, causes the response, which is salivation, even though the two are not directly linked. There's no reason why the bell should cause salivation in the dog. It's the fact that the dog has learnt that the bell is associated with the primary stimulus, which is the food. And hence, you get a conditioned response. The dog salivates when you ring the bell. Most of our responses as humans to different stimuli are usually conditioned. So another reasonable example of this is when the bell rings at the end of a lesson. That's a conditioned response. You've learnt that the end of the lesson, or the bell, usually means the end of the lesson. Now, if you rang the bell at somebody who had no experience of school, then they wouldn't realise that that bell meant the end of the lesson, and hence that's a conditioned response. Okay, so in summary, conditioning is a learned response. Probably the best example of conditioning is to do with Pavlov's dogs. This is where Pavlov linked or rang a bell and placed food down in front of dogs simultaneously. He repeated this process a number of times. He then, on one occasion, removed the food and only rang the bell. The dogs then associated the bell with the food, and hence this caused salivation. So in this example, the food is the primary stimulus, the secondary stimulus is the bell, and the response is salivation. And technically what conditioning is where A secondary stimulus causes a response, even though that the two are not directly linked. And most responses in humans are conditioned or learned responses.